I will basically speaking about the situation of anti-D&T community amidst the COVID-19 and the announced lockdown. In order to understand the situation of D&T community amidst COVID-19, we need to overview the historical background of D&T community in brief. As we are aware that around 198 nomadic tribe communities were notified under Criminal Tribe Act in 1871 under British rule. They were considered as born criminals and subsequently faced stigmatization, discrimination, several restrictions, police brutalities, and violation of their human rights. It has resulted in their marked socio-economic backwardness in terms of education, health, livelihood, and ultimately they acquired the inferior status in the so-called civilized society. The backwardness of D&T community can be seen in as a extreme poverty, high level of migration, low literacy rate, lack of asset, or they are hardly holding any land, food insecurity, poor sanitation, and personal hygiene. From the public health perspective, it is ultimately resulting in higher prevalence of malnutrition, anemia, and higher maternal mortality, infant and child mortality. Mortality is the death of mothers and the children. It is quite high as compared to the other communities. The higher prevalence of malnutrition, anemia, higher child and maternal mortality, the chronic energy deficiency, or we can term it as a malnutrition, is also very much higher among the D&T community in general. And during pregnancy, it can lead to the low birth weight babies, as well as it results in adverse health implications, such as increased risk of disease, physical retardation, and impaired cognitive, that is mental or psychological capabilities, and enhanced risk of maternal mortality. The dietary practices of D&T does not include the balance of all essential nutrients. They consume fewer green vegetables, oil, fruits on a regular basis. According to the World Health Organization, the prolonged energy deficiency during the young age puts the adult population at the high risk of diseases, decreased physical development, and increased incidence as well as prevalence of any infectious disease, including COVID-19 or corona. Likewise, the traditional practices among anti-D&T communities, such as early child marriages and thereby early pregnancies, poses the D&T community to get into the vicious cycle of malnutrition, anemia, low birth weight, and thereby overall underdevelopment of the next generation. The overall public health delivery system is not accountable towards the people in general. We can see that it is hardly accountable. And particularly in case of D&T, they are not at all accountable. On the other hand, the pulling factor, that means the demand of healthcare services by the D&T community is very weak. It is just because of their inferior status in the society, they have internalized the stigma of criminality and also out of the ignorance. During the COVID-19 outbreaks, we can see the situation of D&T community as most vulnerable. The all mentioned social determinants of health makes D&T community more vulnerable towards coronavirus and to develop COVID-19 in a recent scenario. It is well evident that the prevalence of malnutrition under the age of 6 years and anemia among women and adolescent girls is high among tribal community. Similarly, it is also higher in D&T community. However, there is a dearth of data, or rather we can say that there is hardly any data available which can be representative to the D&T community. Thus, the immunity of D&T community towards any infectious disease is very poor. Thereby, they are more prone to acquire corona infection and develop COVID-19 as compared to the any other section of the society. According to the WHO, that is World Health Organization, and numerous scientists, the case fatality rate, that means agar kisi ko corona ho jata hai to uske marne ke chances kitne ho gaye, so that is also called as the case fatality rate of COVID-19. So it is higher among children, elderly people, women, and people those who are having already some comorbidities. कोमॉर्बिडिटीज का मतलब ये होता है, अगर किसी को डायबिटीज है, हाइपरटेंशन है, या किसी हार्ट डिसीज अगर किसी को है ऑलरेडी, तो ऐसे लोगों में मरने की संभावना कोविड से बहुत ज्यादा होती है. तो हियर आई वुड लाइक टू रेफर टू अ स्टडी कंडक्टेड विद अ सबर कम्युनिटी इन पुरुलिया डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल. इट वॉज कंडक्टेड ड्यूरिंग 2019, दैट इज लास्ट ईयर. they found that there is a coexistence of high prevalence of undernutrition, that is malnutrition, among the adult suburban community of Purulia district. That was found, it was found to be around 47% of adult suburban community people, they were suffering from or they were having malnutrition. Along with the malnutrition, they were also having hypertension. Around 37 to 38% of adult suburban community people, they were also suffering from hypertension. Besides that, there is a high prevalence of smoking, chewing tobacco and consumption of alcohol among suburban community, as well as many other D&T communities across India, not only in case of West Bengal or Maharashtra. Hence, we can say that the response of D&T community to COVID-19 would be would not be the same as compared to the mainstream population. The incidence rate among the D&T community would be higher. Subsequently, the death rate due to COVID-19 may be higher than that of the other section of the society due to prevalent malnutrition, comorbidities, and several social determinants of health. The Wire, which is an online platform of journalism, they have recently published, that is just 2 days back, they have published an article where a person from a lower caste has accused caste-based discrimination towards him and his family in a quarantine center. That too in a metropolitan city like Mumbai, here in Mumbai. So we can see that the D&T community, those who have been already suffering from the stigma and discrimination historically, so they are more prone to face caste-based discrimination during the period of COVID-19 as well. Looking at the discriminatory approach of system, I am skeptical whether these people like anti-D&T community would be screened properly in time and what kind of medical treatment they are supposed to get even if they are diagnosed with COVID-19. People from anti-D&T would have to face double burden of consequences of this COVID-19. That is stigma and discrimination, even after the outbreak of COVID-19. Now, let us see the period of the post-COVID period. I don't know whether it will be appropriate to say post-COVID, because as per various scientists across the globe, now we will have to live along with the COVID or coronavirus. So, what can be done towards the welfare or welfare of the anti-D&T community? We need to identify and screen the anti-D&T community by primary health centers, sub-centers, urban health post, and with the help of ASHA worker, Anganwadi worker, nurses, and the local NGOs. Immediately, there should be a provision of mobile dispensaries at the hamlet of anti-D&T communities and on the common route of anti-D&T, where they are seasonally migrating from one place to another. The provision of nutritious food for each family, especially for children, pregnant women, lactating mother and elderly, is of great importance in order to boost their immunity. Government need to adopt and implement the concept of health equity to address the health needs of vulnerable sections, such as with special focus on anti-D&T. We need to enumerate, or government need to enumerate the D&T in census to formulate policies and programs for anti-D&T. The decentralization of health services is utmost important, and the community participation where people from anti-D&T community should also take part in the decision making at the local level. The local, I mean, at the village level, block level, and state level as well. The inter and multi-sectoral approach is very much it is of great importance, because health can be treated from three different departments, majorly the health, ICDS department and PDS department, and we can see that there is a huge lack of communication or harmony between all three departments. There is an immense need to enrich the health right perspective among the special sections like anti-D&Ts, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, and minority groups. Along with that, government should also encourage, or it should also implement, the universal coverage of health services in order to prevent communities from facing any financial hardships because of health. And curbing privatization of health is utmost required, because this is the hard time. Matlab hum bol sakte ki loha abhi garam hai. This is the only time jab government agar chahe to jo privatization hai yahan pe India mein, jisko toda ja sakta hai, aur health system ko it can be make accountable towards welfare of the anti-D&T community in particular. Similarly, since there is hardly any data available, the research in public health, particularly in case of anti-DNT communities, it is of great importance. So this is what I would like to, I wanted to convey to you. If there is any query or clarification, please get back to me. Thank you. Thank you, Mike.